From the Tribune News Network, this is Newsbreak. I'm Krishna Russell. A man accused of five murders faced the courts today over a series of killings dating back to 2018. The appearance comes as the country faces a fresh wave of homicides, with five men killed in separate incidents over the Independence holiday weekend. Police suspect some of the crimes are linked and are the result of retaliation between rival groups, with the first homicide taking place on Thursday. Those court appearances today saw six suspects in court for several murders, including a 25-year-old man accused of five killings, two of which were double homicides. The latest murder took place last night before 6 p.m. in the area of East Street opposite Coconut Grove Avenue. Assistant Superintendent Audley Peters said responding officers arrived at a car wash in the area and were directed to a man who was lying there with apparent gunshot wounds. He was pronounced dead at the scene. ASP Peters said police were told that a group of people were under a shelter at the car wash when a small dark car approached. A man got out of that car and fired shots at the group, fatally wounding the victim. Another man was killed after 10 p.m. on Sunday at Arawakee. Responding officers saw a male victim who was alert and suffering from apparent gunshot wounds. An initial investigation revealed that the victim was approached by a man who produced a handgun and fired the weapon in his direction. The victim was hit about the body several times. The two other killings took place on Independence Day. Shortly before 7 a.m. on July 10th, police were alerted to a shooting incident that happened on Palmetto Road, Sunset Park. A man was found lying in the street with apparent gunshot wounds. He was also taken to hospital and pronounced dead once they arrived there. In the second incident on July 10th, police were called to a shooting in Ridgeland Park West shortly after 9 p.m. Officers there found a man who was lying in the parking lot of an apartment complex on Berkeley Street with wounds consistent with gunshots. EMS pronounced that man dead on the scene. Last week, police also said a man died in hospital after he was shot outside his home in Flamingo Gardens on Thursday night. Police are appealing to anyone with information to come forward to assist with the investigation. COVID-19-related deaths have climbed by 2 to 254, with officials reporting that the country's youngest victim is a 5-month-old girl who died from the virus on June 26th. A 78-year-old New Providence woman who died on July 2nd has also been added to the nation's death count. With COVID-19 numbers and hospital-related cases continuing to climb, former Health Minister Dr. Dwayne Sands said it's very likely the Delta variant could be present in the country and is probably part of the reason why local hospitalizations have increased. Dr. Sands spoke after the country recorded 100 new cases over the holiday weekend, pushing the nation's overall tally to 13,165 as of Saturday. According to data released by the Ministry of Health, 51 new infections were confirmed on Saturday, 49 on Friday, 41 on Thursday, 59 Wednesday, 23 Tuesday, 53 Monday, and 8 on Sunday, July 4th, for a total of 284 last week. The week prior saw 295 cases. 58 people are currently said to be in hospital sick with the virus, with 4 in the intensive care unit. Two pedestrians are dead after separate traffic accidents in New Providence and Grand Bahama over the weekend. The first pedestrian died after being struck by a vehicle in New Providence on Saturday night. Shortly after 9 p.m., police were called to a traffic collision on the Airport Industrial Park Drive. Officers found the man lying in the street unresponsive. A day later, shortly after 10 p.m. on Sunday, Grand Bahama police received a report of a hit and run in the area of Pinedale 8 Mile Rock. Officers found a man lying in the street who appeared to be unresponsive. The victim was taken to hospital and pronounced dead. Anyone with information is asked to come forward. One local family celebrated independence in the best way possible. Mikhail Kemp arrived in this world in the early morning hours of Independence Day at Doctor's Hospital, weighing in at a healthy 7 pounds and 6 ounces. Congratulations from all of us at the Tribune to Mikhail and his father Miguel, Mother Krizika Deshik Kulmer, and all of their family. Your complete news and information source, this is the Tribune News Network. In international news, prices for U.S. consumers jumped in June by the most in 13 years, evidence that a swift rebound in spending has run up against widespread supply shortages that have escalated the cost of many goods and services. Tuesday's report from the Labor Department showed that consumer prices in June rose by 0.9% from May and 5.4% over the past year, the sharpest 12-month inflation spike since August 2008. Excluding volatile oil and gas prices, so-called core inflation rose 4.5% in the past year, the largest increase since November 1991. After Dr. Infani Nsawfor and his wife received two doses of AstraZeneca's coronavirus vaccine in Nigeria, they assumed they would be free to travel this summer to a European destination of their choice. Well, they were wrong. The couple and millions of other people vaccinated through a UN-backed effort could find themselves barred from entering many European and other countries because those nations don't recognize the Indian-made version of the vaccine for travel. Although AstraZeneca vaccine produced in Europe has been authorized by the continent's Drug Regulatory Agency. The same shot manufactured in India hasn't been given the green light. EU regulators said AstraZeneca hasn't completed the necessary paperwork on the Indian factory, including details on its production practices and quality control standards. The Tribune's AccuWeather update, a service of Bahamas Power and Light Company. An upper-level low pressure north of the Bahamas is triggering showers and thunderstorms across the northwest Bahamas through tonight, while a quasi-stationary high-pressure system maintains moderate to fresh breezes across the islands. Mariners in the northwest Bahamas and the Keysal Bank area should be vigilant for possible waterspout activity. Beachgoers should continue to exercise caution due to the risk of rip currents along easterly shores. The public is also advised to stay hydrated during daily high temperatures. There is a risk of localized flooding during heavy showers. For all areas, it'll be variably cloudy, hot, and breezy, with widely scattered showers and isolated thunderstorms, mainly in the northwest Bahamas, with isolated showers elsewhere through tonight. Small craft caution continues. Expect gusty winds and higher seas in or near heavy showers and thunderstorms. Winds easterly at 15 to 20 knots. Seas 4 to 6 feet over the ocean. We'll have a daytime high temperature of 90 degrees and an overnight low temperature of 75. There will be a heat index of 102. The sun will set this afternoon at 8 p.m. and will rise tomorrow morning at 6:29. That's Newsbreak. Details of the day's top stories in the Tribune newspaper, now on the streets. Or stay up to date online at Tribune242.com.